Okay, hello student, welcome back. And today we are going to continue our video series revision for SPM. Previously we did until here. Let's read number 12. Let's just take some eraser to erase all these things first. I have to press eraser. Erase all this, not enough space. Hey, what is this? Why I cannot erase this one? Oh my goodness. Okay, so let's read this question. There are two types of fats, saturated fat and unsaturated fat. So what does it mean by saturated fat and unsaturated fat? Okay, very good. So what do you mean by saturated? Which one is more healthy?
Unsaturated. Unsaturated. Yeah.
Unsaturated fat. Because saturated fat is actually usually they come from animal. And unsaturated fat come from plant. So of course from animal you get a higher cholesterol. If you want to look at the chemical properties, saturated fat means that it is it only contains single bond of chemical. If you draw out the chemical the thing, the diagram, and unsaturated fat actually got a double bond. So actually it got less hydrogen. This is one more hydrogen. In the molecule, there is extra one hydrogen molecule. I had a hydrogen atom. So one is less one hydrogen, one is more hydrogen. So of course, more means higher cholesterol. And sometimes in the, when we buy something, sometimes they put it as trans fat. So what do we mean by there's no trans fat? Probably, we are talking about saturated fat and say no trans fat, or that I like to read the behind label, that this one dehydrogenated. There's a word like hydrogenated, or hydrogenated means you is a saturated there's a word not hydrogenated or hydrogenated. So actually it also means saturated or unsaturated. So look out for this when you buy oil in the supermarket. When you buy margarine or butter, and you just Google a bit, the hydrogenated or the saturated or unsaturated, or okay, I forgot the word but you can just Google it. Then you will buy the good butter and oil for your family. Google. Usually for unsaturated is slightly expensive, maybe expensive 2-3 ringgit, 4 or 5 ringgit, but it is much more healthier than the saturated fat that you buy in the supermarket. And okay. it even tastes healthier. Oh, so not only we study, but we can use it in life. What is mean by saturated fat? We can say that saturated fat has high cholesterol from the animal, okay? Has high cholesterol. Generated from the animal. Yeah, okay. One is plant, but that's why they sell corn oil, some more what oil, coconut oil. Hey, coconut oil also got slightly cholesterol. Some more got what, sunflower oil. Whatever lah, the palm oil. Palm oil also is good. It's a plant oil. And of course, there's a cheaper oil. I think it's a saturated oil. There's a packet 2 ringgit one usually they use to make roti canai one, because roti canai they just two ringgit on, but you eat a lot of roti canai, it's not healthy lah, because you roti canai is using unsaturated fat, saturated fat. But when your mom cook at home, I believe all of them are using unsaturated oil, which is much more healthier. Diagram 2.11.1 show 3 example of unsaturated oil. So there's a palm oil, peanut oil, and corn oil, depend on what taste that you want. Study the information in diagram 1, construct the concept for unsaturated fat. And never mind, yeah, we can choose, but never mind, we just discuss this for fun. Discuss the concept. So in an experiment, a few things that is very difficult to do in an experiment, in the research in the experiment. One is the concept, another one is the problem statement. Now, this is the two toughest questions that usually in an experiment we need to do, because the hypothesis is easy, okay? The hypothesis, tabulation of data, conclusion, procedure usually is easy, and a few one is difficult, which I believe is the problem statement and also the concept. So basically what they are asking, to construct the concept. What are the concept for this experiment? Concept. So you need to conceptualize the you know concept, right? you need to make it into a, this is actually a concept already. This is actually a con, mean the frame of concept already. They already do a frame in the concept. But you need to conceptualize it. Means maybe you can explain more about this. Explain the concept. So what are the explanation that you want to put?
Okay.
Uh-huh. So
like explain like each type of oil, is it?
Yeah. It actually is to, yeah, you can do that because that is also a concept. So the one concept is an unsaturated fat. We know that unsaturated fat, example of unsaturated fat is corn oil, peanut oil, and peanut oil. So this is actually the concept. So if you write like this, you already got one mark for this one. Huh? This itself is already a concept. The concept of unsaturated fat is corn oil, example, palm oil and peanut oil. So what other concept that we can get from this diagram? Very good. They're produced by plant. They're originated from plant. Okay, they are from plant. Some more.
They have lower cholesterol level.
They have lower cholesterol level. Very good. Okay, they have lower cholesterol level. That is also a concept. Lower cholesterol. Some more. Because there is a 6 mark, eh? So we have 3 already. We still need another 3. Some more, what concept we can say? Lower cholesterol, some more we can say what?
Yeah,
we can say what?
Yeah, liquid.
They are liquid at what temperature? Liquid at
room temperature.
At room temperature. Okay, they are liquid at room temperature. And for saturated fat, is actually they are a bit like solid in the room temperature. That's why when you eat curry mee and the curry become cold, you can see that there is like a jelly on top of the curry mee. When the curry mee cool down or you put in the fridge, you will get the layer. So you know that it is a saturated fat, but for unsaturated, it is still liquid at room temperature. So you can notice the difference when you are eating. And some more, maybe we can say that it has low melting point. Both of this has low melting point. And lastly, point number 6, we can say that another example is olive oil, for example. Okay, another example is olive oil. Okay, Ken, so these are the characteristics, the characteristic and the concept. I would recommend students don't do this also. If you can choose, then you don't do this. Because as I mentioned, the question that asking about concept and problem statement is one of the most difficult question even for a researcher. So you might want to choose this question. Okay, see. Diagram 11.2 show a few examples of food that have been taken by a person who suffer from heart disease. So usually what causes heart disease?
Too much intake of cholesterol.
Too much intake of cholesterol or
high cholesterol food. High cholesterol, high salt, high fat content.
Will cause heart disease because your blood vessel eventually, the lumen will become smaller. It will become smaller because your fat layer, this is a healthy vessel, but your fats will be accumulated at the vessel, so the vessel, the pipe will get smaller. Eventually, it will clog and it will burst. And when it bursts or clog, it will either stroke, it will have a stroke in your body if it clog in your brain or other part, depending on which part of the body. If brain, then you usually die, because sometimes you die because the blood clog in the brain and when the thing bursts, the blood will spill everywhere to your brain, and I don't know how. Usually people can die due to this. That's why it's always recommended, K-Bike question, it always recommended that a person always exercise and maintain a healthy diet. Of course, salt also the same. Salt will raise your blood pressure. Blood pressure means your blood will go faster, and then you go faster, then many things will happen also, because you got high blood pressure due to the high consumption of salt. Exercise, drink more water, burn more fat, so that it's better. Okay, so of course you have a heart disease, you could have a heart disease due to the fat and the cholesterol. In your opinion, is the food suitable taken by the patient? Yes or no?
No.
No. No, you will get 1 mark. Very good.
Okay, then
at least this is
explain.
So you need to explain 4 mark, you need to explain 3 reasons. So can you give me 3 reasons why you cannot eat this?
Can I just put it in one sentence, or I need to divide? Put in.
It's better to make
put in few sentences.
Yeah, because it is, you can make all in one sentence, but can you like lah, but I think you make 3 is better, because it's easier for the examiner to mark and easier for the examiner to give mark. So can you tell me the 3 points? Maybe just the point lah, no need the sentence, just the point.
Okay. This is because cake.
Yeah, cake.
And ice cream contains high amount of sugar.
Okay, cake and ice cream. High amount of sugar, okay? And then?
Beef burger.
Okay, beef burger.
Contains high level of fats and sodium.
Fats and sodium, okay? And then?
Too much intake of the food above will lead to more health problems.
Okay, this one I will give mark, this one I give mark, this one I don't think I give mark for health problem, because
need to be specific.
Yeah, because it is because the question tell you ask you what problem, then it will lead to more problem. So what should you, how can you improve this answer?
Too much intake of the food above will cause the patient to worsen his condition.
Okay, so maybe you can say that because it's a 4 mark, so you can say no, because cake and ice cream got high level of sugar, you get 1 mark. It will cause diabetes, 1 mark. And then you can say beef sugar and ice cream got whatever or got high cholesterol, and high cholesterol will lead to heart disease, such as heart attack, so you get another 1 mark. Okay, so 1 mark is for high sugar, another keyword is diabetes, 1 mark is high fat, the keyword is heart disease or stroke if you want to, or high blood pressure. Heart disease is the best heart disease for the fat. So you're explaining, because I'm not explaining like what problem you have, you will have the heart problem like heart attack. So it answer the question. If not, the question asks you what's the problem. The problem leads to more health problem. So that is it.
Too general.
Yeah, too general. Okay, maybe we can finish this with the last question.
Okay.
This one also is the... Okay, so the question asks us to choose. So I think for C is easy. I think they purposely do like that one. They give 2 questions easy. Main question hard. Let's read 13 questions, see is it easier. Alcohol is the main kind, explain the fermentation to produce alcohol. So this one A is, I think, slightly difficult. Main difficult, I heard that when content is expensive. So well, this one is more like BM question. So I think you just need to answer in the BM style. I mean like the essay file. What is the effect of masalah, ketagihan, alcohol. Alcohol, yeah. A lot of you in beneficial. I think these two is easy. And only this one is slightly difficult. So
yes.
Yeah. Up to you, but I will choose this one lah because BM question you can write more.
Yeah, K but.
Yeah, it's a K but. So that this one is more towards the biological part, huh? And the concept part is the research part. 13, alcohol a lot of benefit to mankind to its process to control under strict supervision. Explain the fermentation process to produce alcohol. So what can you explain the fermentation process?
Something
covered
into alcohol?
Yeah, correct. So what is the fermentation process? Roughly we know that in order to make something fermented, what you need to use? You need to use glucose plus what?
Glucose plus yeast.
Glucose plus yeast, and what you will get?
Then we'll get alcohol and carbon dioxide.
Alcohol and carbon dioxide. Okay? Alcohol plus carbon dioxide. You can either put here alcohol or ethanol. Alcohol is the main word for ethanol, propanol, butanol, then pentanol, isopropyl. Alcohol, if you buy the sanitizer, you can look behind, there is a specific name for the alcohol. We know this is the alcohol sanitizer, but if you look behind, you can read the alcohol name. I think it's isopropyl propene, something like that. It's the alcohol that we use for sanitization. So glucose plus yeast, you will get alcohol plus carbon dioxide, you will get 1 mark. And then we need to explain this one. So maybe you can explain this like
2 marks only.
Yeah lah, 1 mark is for the equation, another mark is for the explanation. Yeah, so maybe you can explain like in the fermentation process, the yeast will undergo a respiration process, and through the respiration, it will convert the glucose into
ethanol
and carbon dioxide, something like this. Okay, so you can say that. But of course, this respiration is possible due to the lack of oxygen. If you want to do it, you need to close it. And due to lack of oxygen in the bottle, but they still want to undergo a respiration process, so eventually it will produce ethanol or alcohol and carbon dioxide, because you need to close the bottle. You don't add oxygen lah. Later you add oxygen, you just get back the carbon dioxide, you don't get the alcohol. So this is a very slow process, so that's why maybe one of the why alcohol is expensive, because you cannot do it very fast. Maybe you need put 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. Sometimes the beer or what, if you want to put it 1 year, 2 year or 3 year to get a better taste. I don't know how they do lah. That's why sometimes it is expensive due to the skill and the effort that you need to put in. But okay, this one just 1 mark. I think this is a very good question. But this one I think you know. Just write this, you get a 1 mark. You cannot explain. B. Many individuals have been addicted to alcohol. They have been currently consuming alcohol. In your opinion, what are the effect of alcohol? What are the effect to physical and mental health? What are the effect?
Mentally is will disrupt the coordination.
Correct. Okay.
Disrupt the body coordination.
You get 1 mark. Okay. And.
And then physically will affect the kidney. Liver.
Correct. It will affect the liver. Very good.
Yeah.
So just like the key point lah. Liver. It will affect your coordination. Some more. Need two more because it's 4 mark.
So
maybe you can say that it will
damage the brain.
It will damage the brain. No, it will slow down your response.
Yeah,
it will slow down your response. So it slow down your response, and it many things you can write. It slow down your response and affect your coordination. Therefore, you cannot drive car because you have lost your coordination and you are slow to respond through the impulse, and also you will make a poor judgment psychologically. You will make a poor judgment. So if you work as a judge, you cannot take alcohol. Even the Bible say it lah. If you take if you are certain position, and one of it is judge lah. I think the book of Proverbs say that you cannot take alcohol. It's already mentioned because it will interfere with your judgment, and it will cause hallucination, and it will cause a lot of health problem as well. And,
okay.
It will cause even death. If you want to write, huh? Some people drink alcohol until death because it's called the what poisoning? Alcohol poisoning or that's a word lah, huh? If you drink too much, you will just die on the spot. Okay, I think enough for psychologically and physically. How about question C? Alcohol has a lot of uses and benefit, and it got a benefit under good supervision or under strict control, under good supervision. State the user alcohol. So how you want to use alcohol? 6 mark. So you need to 6 mark. Many things you can say.
Medical purposes.
Medical.
They can be used to produce medicine.
To produce medicine such as maybe we can say
the antiseptic.
Okay, antiseptic. Yeah, medication we can use it to produce antiseptic. If you got wound, you can use it to kill the microorganism.
Yes.
Some more. You can even say like maybe as a sanitizer. Alcohol, you can use it. Now got COVID, we use it everywhere for sanitization. Some more what we can say. What is the use of alcohol?
To drink.
To drink.
Control drinking.
Oh yeah, can to drink.
Yeah.
Can to drink.
Then I don't know really.
To drink. Some faster lah thing lah. Try to think. What's the like BM question? Kegunaan alcohol dalam kehidupan manusia.
For the cooking.
For cooking, yes, it's not in the marking scheme, but I think it is correct. Okay, for cooking, because Chinese
add flavor.
Chinese people put in the
liao chu.
How's the taste lah? You increase the enhance the taste. Some more got what? As a fuel to burn something, and lastly, some more. We need one more. As a cleaner for cosmetic. Okay, or as a solvent also can. So we can say that. But you don't write keyword in the exam. You say okay, the users can be used for any medication. It can use as an antiseptic to kill the microorganism. It also can use as a sanitizer to be used to kill the virus and so on. It also can be used to drink for. It also can be produced as a liquid for human to drink, and it also can be used to produce good taste. It can be used in cooking. Then you just make a sentence lah, huh? This is not English class, so you can make any sentence, but don't write on this don't just write one word. I'm saying the keyword Okay, so any question?
No.
Okay, so I think I'll be teaching until here, and I see you next time.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Bye, thank you.